Howdy, I'm Rex Hooper, and I love westerns. My favorite thing about westerns is the music. My favorite western music comes from the spaghetti westerns. More specifically, my favorite spaghetti western composer, heck, my favorite film composer of all time, is Ennio Morricone, the maestro himself. Ennio Morricone is an Italian film composer. Born in 1928, he scored over 400 movies, 70 of which were award-winning films. And for my money, he is the greatest film composer of all time. Ennio Morricone reinvented the sound of the Western. And ever since the great scores, the Western scores of Ennio Morricone, the sound of the West has changed forever. Ennio Morricone, with his enormous back catalog of music, means it would do us all an injustice to pick a top 5 Ennio Morricone songs. So instead, we're going all the way to top 10 best Ennio Morricone songs. At number 10, A Fistful of Dollars. A Fistful of Dollars was Ennio Morricone's first Western film score, and it's incredible. Why it's incredible is because of the interesting instrumentation. Due to budget constraints, he didn't have the use of a full orchestra, so he fills up the sound with electric guitar. The electric guitar, which was popular at the time that the movie was coming out, was not popular for film score, but it seems to fit absolutely perfectly. I can't quite explain it. Why a film set in the 1800s perfectly matches the twangy electric guitar of the 1960s, but hey, it does work. Fistful of Dollars. At number 9, Two Mules for Sister Sara. A great western and a great score. One of the things that Morricone does that's so innovative with this score is the woodwind sounds like the braying off a mule. More than a western soundtrack, one of the things that's great about this score is the horror element. Morricone would go on to make some of the best horror movie soundtracks after his western ventures, and maybe Two Mules for Sister Sara hints at that future. At number 8, The Great Silence. The Great Silence is a really great movie and an unsung gem of the western genre. One of the things that's great about it, this movie, is that score by Morricone. Morricone was doing something different with this movie. The Great Silence isn't set in the desert, and you've got very unconventional characters and a particularly unconventional ending, so it meant that he couldn't rely on his usual bag of tricks. It's a very different sound to a western soundtrack, and yet it fits perfectly. It's mysterious, it's majestic, it's pure Morricone. Number 7, The Mercenary. The Mercenary, oh, what a majestic, courageous score. For me, it is the sound of bravery, of destiny, and the greatest feature of that score is the beautiful whistling. Morricone is a genius, but of course, like any genius, they got a little help from their friends. And Morricone's friend is the great whistler, known as the whistle. The whistling in all of Morricone's soundtracks is made by Alessandro Alessandrone. And this incredible virtuoso whistling is all throughout this wonderful track for The Mercenary. At number 6, Navajo Joe. Navajo Joe is one of my personal favorite spaghetti westerns. It has a Native American protagonist, and Morricone's score infuses Native American sounds into that soundtrack. The drums and the war whoops and the cries of Native American chants adds to an excitement to the whole movie. It's a particularly violent spaghetti western, and a lot of that violence is felt in the music itself. Navajo Joe. Morricone's influence on film history and music history has forever shaped the landscape of the sound of the Western. His influence also rubbed off on me when I made my record, Frontera USA. You could check it out on the Bandcamp, on the Spotify, and wherever else you listen to your music. Check out Frontera USA, my Western soundtracks. At number 5, for a few dollars more, another absolute classic of the Western genre. For a few dollars more was the second movie that Sergio Leone and Clint Eastwood did for what would become the Man with No Name trilogy. Even though Clint Eastwood's character always did have a name, but that's another video. For a few dollars more was bigger in every way from the previous film, Fistful of Dollars. And the score was bigger too, using more instruments, including one of my personal favorites, the jaw harp. It is bigger, it's more bombastic, it's more romantic, it's more everything. For a few dollars more. At number 4, The Ecstasy of Gold. The Ecstasy of Gold is a track featured in the movie soundtrack for The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly, but it is a track that stands out on its own. The Ecstasy of Gold is such a beautiful, romantic piece, and has all the hallmarks you expect of a Morricone Western score. The bravery, the determination, the courage, but underneath it, an air of tragedy. Just like the tragedy that we all face in our futile quest for gold. Number 3, Death Rides a Horse. Death Rides a Horse tells the story of a man coming to face the consequences of his deeds in the past. And Morricone's score here that is more aggressive, more pounding, more evil than any of his previous efforts is the sound of that past catching up with you. At number 2, Man with a Harmonica. Man with a Harmonica is featured in the movie Once Upon a Time in the West, one of the great westerns of all time. The music for Once Upon a Time in the West was recorded before any frame of the movie was ever shot. Morricone worked on this soundtrack before any of the plotting or ideas for the movie. So, the movie was born out of the music itself, which makes it fairly unique in all of cinema history, where the music is always made after the movie is done. The advantage of having the music before any of the filming began was that the director, Sergio Leone, could play the music to the actors on set while they were filming, and that would dictate the rhythm, the tone, and the emotion of the scenes. At number 1, the greatest Ennio Morricone song is, of course, The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly. The Good and the Bad and the Ugly main theme is one of the most iconic sounds in all of cinema history. Regardless of its place in the Western genre, it's left its mark on all of movie history. It's as iconic and as recognizable as Bernard Herrmann's theme for Psycho or John Williams' theme for Star Wars. The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly has the sound of bravery, determination, and mystery infused throughout it. Often, the Westerns and Western cinema is trying to mythologize the sound of the Old West. And what Ennio Morricone is doing with this soundtrack is infusing those myths with a majesty that's fit for the heroes and villains and all the ugliness in between. Well, there it is, folks. My top 10 Ennio Morricone songs. And if I've missed out your favorite Morricone track, then let me know in the comments section below. And if you've taken anything from this video, maybe a recommendation to listen to some more Morricone, then give that like button a hit. Hit that subscribe button too. Don't cost you anything. It helps support this channel. You can also support this channel, as I've mentioned, by checking out my record, Frontera USA. Not as good as Morricone, but then who is? Alright, I'll see you later on, cowpokes. Further on down the trail.